Grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Inside the bulletin is a sermon outline if you'd like to follow along as we journey with Israel and we see how God works amongst his people. I mean, I don't know about you, but I tend to get excited about the good things where I get to see how God is working, and sometimes I forget the lesser things, you know, like when I don't get my way, that God is still working as our Father, caring for us and directing us. But in the Old Testament reading, you get to see God meet with his people. I mean, this is amazing stuff. The people of Israel have wandered through the wilderness, and there we find them at the base of Mount Sinai. This is the close of the Book of the Covenant for the people of God. This is God saying, I will be your God, and the people replying back, we will be your people. Remember how they say that? All these things we will do. No, all these things we will gladly do, that being the Ten Commandments, the Book of the Covenant. And then God says, okay, I'll do my part. He knows they're not going to do their part, but he still promises to do his part, and so he descends to meet with his people there on Mount Sinai. And so in chapter 19, he tells all of Israel, don't set a foot on the mountain, lest you die. Don't let your cattle graze on the mountain, lest they die. Don't even throw a stone onto the mountain, lest the presence of the Lord break out against you. I mean, this is terrifying stuff. Because when the Lord descends on Mount Sinai, they look up, and not only do they get to see like pavement, like sapphire, clear as crystal, they get to see the fire of God devouring what looks like the top of the mountain. This is scary stuff. And so everybody stays away, except for those who have been covered by the blood. The blood that paid for their sins. So Moses and Aaron, Nadab and Abihu, and the 70 elders of Israel who have been sprinkled with the blood of this covenant that God will pay for their sins, they are able to go up onto the mountain of the Lord, and they eat and behold God and enjoy his presence. See, God has been meeting with his people, Israel, all throughout their history. This cloud that covers the mountain was the same pillar of cloud that led them out of Israel or out of Egypt. I mean, this isn't anything new for them. And yet, can you imagine the imprint it would have had on their minds? Every memory that when they saw a cloud, ooh, God's presence is with us. Every time they saw God as a devouring fire, oh, the Lord, Yahweh himself is with us. Because that's how God worked with his people, to be present with them all through their history. In fact, we see that God is present in smoke. The call of Isaiah, you remember, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. The whole earth is full of his glory. What that is describing is what Isaiah saw in Isaiah chapter 6 when God said, come, be my servant. You are going to be my prophet. In fact, the one whom we call the Prince of Prophets. And so smoke fills the entire temple because God was present with Isaiah. And what does Isaiah say? Holy cow. Oh, wait, no, he says, oy vey, woe to me, I am undone. Which the Hebrew word there literally means all my joints have all of a sudden stopped working. I mean, he falls to a puddle on the ground because God's presence, the smoke, God's presence is right there. And he says, woe to me, I am a man of unclean lips, and I live amongst a people of unclean lips, and God's holiness has broke out against us. But God has a remedy. Just as he did for Moses and Aaron, Nadab and Abihu, the 70 elders with the blood, God sends a seraphim to take a coal from the altar and touch it, to Isaiah's lips. And God says, I have made your words pure. I have made your words holy. God being present in the smoke works. Can you imagine every time you see that little pillar of smoke rising up from a candle that you fell down on your face and said, God is present. And God continued to be present with his people even after the Old Testament. We see it on the Mount of Transfiguration. Jesus takes with him Peter, James, and John, and indeed he's transfigured there before them, and his face shines like light, but it's not until the cloud swallows them up, much like it did Mount Sinai. It swallows the people up, and Peter, James, and John fall to their face terrified, because they knew what it meant. God was present with them. The holy and awesome God that they worshiped and adored was present with his people there on the mountain of transfiguration. And he spoke, this Jesus, he is my beloved son. With him I am well pleased. And he instructs them, listen to him. God had continued to work through the Old Testament and the New Testament through smoke and through cloud, just as he had through fire. God speaks to his people and shows his presence there at Mount Sinai as though he were a devouring fire, because God's holiness, well, it could break out against you. I mean, think about the poor priests who reached out and touched his hand on the Ark of the Covenant when he wasn't supposed to. What happened to him, Eldon? He was no more. Those who gathered outside the tent of meeting, bringing charges against Moses and Aaron, God's servants, what happened to them? Fire came out of the tent of meeting and devoured them. The holiness of God breaks out against people and it terrifies us. And so God chooses to meet with his people through means, through smoke. Still terrifying, because they know the holy God is present with them. Through cloud, because they know the holy God is speaking to them as he is present with them. And yes, through fire, that his holiness burns away all the dross. And inside you and inside me, there is plenty of dross and sin and imperfection. But you, just like Moses, Aaron, Nadab, Abihu, the 70 elders, and all those who believe, have been covered with the blood of the new covenant. The blood of God's own Son, Jesus Christ, given for you. And now you get to see God working in a new and different means. Not through smoke and cloud and fire, but something far more certain than smoke, cloud, and fire. You get to see God's presence through what Peter calls, with more certainty than all of those things. You get to know God's presence in his word, where he declares that that blood of the new covenant, his blood, covers every one of your sins. That this Jesus who was on the mountain of transfiguration still speaks to you today through this holy word. That you can come into the presence of God knowing that he has made you pure and you clean and you holy because of this more certain revelation of God's presence. And know that he will not break out against you, but instead will cover you with grace just as the cloud covered that mountain. That he will devour all your sins and remove them, never to be remembered again, just as that devouring fire covered him. And just as you see the smoke arise into the heavens, so too will he hear your prayers. Because God has given his word, revealed that he is present with us, in a far more certain way than smoke and cloud and fire, but in his holy word, which is given for you to read each and every day. A word that declares that this word made flesh is my beloved son. May we listen to him. Amen. Now may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, guard and keep your hearts and your minds with Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.